Hi, I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week we're going to talk about thin gauge polyesters, why you want to use a really thin gauge and a poly and what you can kind of get out of them. So I've got some examples right here. First up, I've got one of the first polys I ever hit, actually, but I hit it in a thicker 16 gauge. But this is the 18 gauge version of Kirschbaum Competition, and it comes in a 1.20 millimeter. And so when you're talking about gauges, the higher the number is going to give you the thinner the gauge. And when you go to the millimeter reference to the string thickness, obviously the lower the number is going to give you the thinner gauge. So just make sure you keep that one clear. So an 18 gauge for Kirschbaum is a 1.20 millimeter right there. I've got V-Torque Tour here from Vocal, and this one's a 19 gauge string, and this one's a 1.10 millimeter string. So pretty thin, going to offer some nice bite on the ball right there. And then also we've got some Head Hawk Touch, also in a 19 gauge, and this one's a 1.15 millimeter. So you're going to notice that millimeter difference, there's going to be a little bit of difference right there between the brands. Then I've got a 20 gauge Selinko Tour Bite, and that's a 1.05. So that's a really, really thin gauge poly. And right here in my racket right now, we're testing for a review some Selinko Tour Bite, and I've got it in the 19 gauge. What it does is it's a much thinner string, so it's going to reduce the swing weight of my racket. It's a little bit less mass up in here just because I have less thickness to the string. So it's going to bring my swing weight down, and my racket's going to make my racket feel a little bit more maneuverable. So that's one advantage right there. Another one is it's going to open up the string pattern. This racket has a pretty open string pattern. This is the Power Stab new racket from Technofiber, the 300 in the T-Flash line. And this one's got a pretty open string pattern, but if you've got a really dense string pattern racket, like an 18-20 mid, something like that, using a really thin gauge poly is going to really open up that pattern and get it playing a little bit livelier. And in any pattern, you're going to get a slightly higher launch angle out of your racket with this thin gauge. It's going to offer some really nice bite on the ball as well. And so that higher launch angle is going to give you easier access to depth into the court. It's going to give you some nice arc on your spin serves, especially. And with that thin gauge too, it's going to really let the ball sink into the string bed. You're going to get nice ball pocketing and bite. So the feel is really good too. I enjoy that very much with these thin gauges. And then you get the spin, which complements that higher arc. So even though I'm hitting the ball higher over the net and I'm getting that depth, I'm getting the nice rotation on the ball to help it drop and stay within the lines. One of the things to be aware of, it's a thinner gauge. It's going to sound a little pingier. You're going to get a nice high-pitched ping from the racket because you've gone with a thinner gauge, thinking if you're playing a musical instrument, the thinner the string, the higher the pitch sound. So you're going to get that from there. It's going to sound like it's strung tighter. That's just an effect you're going to get from that sound, but it's actually not going to play that way at all. It's going to play a little bit livelier too. And I actually like to bump my tension up a couple of pounds when I go in a thinner gauge just to tame the liveliness of the string. I do like the way it lets the ball really sink into the string bed and pocket it. Gives me that really nice feel. Another good thing you can do with a thin gauge poly, if you're a string breaker, you're going to be probably breaking the thinner gauges, especially the 20 gauges, fairly quickly. But you can put a thicker gauge in the mains and throw the thin gauge in the crosses just to open it up a little bit and get some of that spin pocketing and launch angle out without sacrificing too much durability. So you've got that hybrid option as well. But if you're not a heavy string breaker and you want to maximize that control of a poly, but get a little bit more power on your shots, maybe you're just coming into polys, I think a thin gauge copolyester is a great way to go. And there's some reasons why I think you should give one a try. If you haven't tried it yet, even if you are a string breaker, I think you owe it to yourself just to find out what these thin gauges are about and how they're going to feel in your racket. Be sure to send us your comments on our YouTube channel and let us know how it works out for you. That's all I've got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.